To begin sewing our bag, I'm going to start with our lining fabric. If you remember, our lining fabric was 32.5 inches high by 23 inches wide. I'm going to fold it in half, the 32.5 inch direction, and we're going to sew up the two short sides. So let's go ahead and get those pinned. With our two sides pinned together, we're ready to go ahead and sew them. So the second side, and you do want to lock stitch at both ends when you're sewing your pieces. Now I will set my lining piece aside, and I'm going to take the two pocket pieces and we're going to pin them right sides together and then sew them. When you sew your two pieces for your pocket together, you want to remember to leave about 3 inches of an opening so that you can turn it right side out. So I'm going to begin sewing at this yellow pin. And I am using 1/2 inch seam allowances for this project. Again, lock stitching as you start. Pivot at the corners. Again, I'm going to stop at the pin that we have so that I have that 3-inch opening. And now with your opening, you can go ahead and turn your pocket right side out. And then you're going to come back and press this. Actually, before I turn it right side out, I'm going to go ahead and cut the corners off so that I have nice tight corners when I turn it right side out. So if I just cut them off, cutting off a little triangle at each corner, making sure you don't cut through your stitch line. If you poke into each corner with your fingernail, you can go ahead and get those pretty much pushed out, but sometimes you might need to stick something in there like the end of a pencil or scissors. Okay, and when we attach our pocket to our bag, we'll then close this opening shut or so. Now we're ready to go ahead and sew our handles. So what I've done is I've taken my 6-inch wide strip and I ironed it folded in half, and then I ironed it folding the two sides into the middle, and then we'll fold it in half. So now we end up having 4 layers of thickness to make our straps, and we'll just go ahead and sew down the edge. You can pin this if you need to. So for stitching down this first side, I'm sewing about 1/4 inch away from the edge of the fabric. And I'm also going to go down the second side and do the same thing so that you have a nice consistent look down both edges of your handle. And there you can see we got both sides of the strap stitched down. Now I'm taking the sides of my bags and we're going to sew them to the bottom. So you're going to take one side and sew it to one side of the bottom of the bag. Now this is where I'm going to be using a cording. So I'm going to put a decorative cording in between the layers. You don't have to do that. You could just simply sew it this way without the cording, but we'll be putting a cording right in between the two layers. So I'm going to go ahead and pin that in there. And I'll also be switching to a zipper foot on our sewing machine so that I can get up nice and close to that cord. Okay, turn that around, take my other side piece, decide which way is up. And pin that together as well. Again, putting my cording in between. Okay, now I'm going to go ahead and switch on my sewing machine and put my zipper foot on, and we'll be ready to stitch these two sides up. So I'm at the sewing machine. Just to show you again, this is our bag bottom. This is our decorative cording piece, and then this is the sides of our bag. And I've switched already over to my zipper foot. So now I'm just going to put this underneath the sewing machine foot. Drop the presser foot down, remove this first pin, and we'll just start sewing. So the second side. Now let's take a look. So if we pull the sides back, You can see here's our bottom, our decorative trim that we added for detail, and then our side pieces. Now what I want to do is pull a little bit of the cord out of the cording, so back about half, 3/4 of an inch, so that it's not in my seam allowance when I sew. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to force the fabric back on the cord. You don't want to pull too hard on the cord because you don't want to pull it all the way out of your fabric, but you want to cut back about a half, 3/4 of an inch. And then that way when you stitch your side seams, you won't have cording in the side seam. Then you'll just use your hands to slide it back up. And now the cord ends there and this part of the fabric is all hollow. So I'm going to do that on all 4 ends. You do need to work it a little bit. Before we sew up the sides of our bag, we're going to go ahead and attach our pocket to one side of the bag. I've gone ahead and pinned it centered left to right, and I've brought it down almost up against my cording where my intersection between my base or bottom cloth and my top cloth is, because I want to make sure I leave room at the top so that when we finish off the edges, we don't accidentally close our pocket shut. One other thing I've done is I've put 2 pins in an X formation at the top of the pocket so I don't accidentally sew that closed. Lift the presser foot and just pivot my fabric. And I've rolled the bottom up so that it stays out of my way. Actually, I need to do a couple more stitches here. I'm not quite far enough down. There we go, that should be good. I'm just going to do a little lock stitch at this bottom corner, just because being a pocket, you want to make sure it's nice and strong. Sewing machine's wiggling on the table here. I'll just adjust. Again, I'm going to lock stitch at this corner as well. Pivot one more time. And now we'll go up the last side. So let's go ahead and get this out of the way. I drop the presser foot back down. Let's pull it out and cut our threads. Now I'll go ahead and pull out all my pins. And there you can see we now have our pocket, and because of my X pins at the top, I didn't sew it closed.